All right, guys, welcome back. In this video, we're going to expand on this function here, and we're actually going to implement arguments into the function. So what this means is this is very static right now. Nothing would change this even if we wanted to change it. I could call this function, let's say 10 times, and each time it's going to print out very static strings. So how we can change this to make it more dynamic is by using arguments. And the arguments, again, go in the brackets here at the end of the function name. And what you're doing is creating a variable. So we don't even need to know the value that's being passed in. We just, let's decide to use two arguments here in this function. And each one is going to be used in its own print statement. So we're going to name it str1 and str2. There. And this basically we've abbreviated string1 and string2. It also tells us right now it's not being used. You're going to find PyCharm pretty smart. So what we're going to do is change this line of code to print out string1. Then we're going to use this print statement to print out str2. And let's go ahead and save it and run it. We're going to get an error. And the reason is because we're calling this function without passing anything into it. And it actually tells us right here, parameter string1 unfilled. So it knows that this function is looking for two values here separated by a comma. One of them is string1 and one of them is string2. We haven't passed anything into it. So it's calling this function and immediately the function is freaking out saying, I can't find this information. So what we need to do is pass in two strings here. And how we do that is similar to how it looks in here, except each one is going to be the value and not the variable name. So the first one is going to be called this is argument1, then make a comma. This is the second argument, which is also a string. Now if we save, go ahead and run, you're going to see that this is now printing out string1 as defined right here, and string2 as defined right here. So why would we need to do this? Well, let's say we're always going to want to print out two things. Let's go ahead and call the function again, but this time we're going to pass in different strings. Just fall back to the good old hello world. Now we're going to save this, and what's going to happen is it's going to print out four lines. It's going to print out this is argument one, this is the second argument, which is being called from the first call of that function, and then stringy and hello world from the second call of that function. And so that's how to use arguments. Now in the next video, we're going to be discussing keyword arguments and what those are.